Hello World, and we are back in Warplane Orange. Our Plating Campaign as the Allies. So, let us see what the Combaton has in store for us now. We are going to... we commanded our fleet to move towards Manila last turn. So we will see how it goes. Maybe he will see his fleet approaching Hong Kong. So. Yeah. Okay, all 16 at Tsing Tao. Well, Inoki is unsinkable from torpedoes. We know that. We see a task force, Japanese one, and he bombards at Manila. Mr. Yamashiro, that's business as usual. And again, two bombardments. With the heat sense in Nagato, interesting. So, wow, 500 casualties. Oof. And the sets are a lot. I guess a high amount of disruption, too. Oof. We will see. So that was the night phase. Yeah. So what can we see at the air operations? Not really. But a lot of ships at Manila. With two Japanese task forces, where the Nagato and the Mashiro are the problematic ships. The Nagato even more, but it has only one pre-dreadnought battleship with it. A better one. The Heatsen with the 12 inches at least, but... And he's shock attacking at Manila. Woohoo! And the Philippine division should looks really bad. I guess they were hit quite a lot from the bombardment. This high amount of disruption and fatigue, I guess. Or at least disruption. Oof. Yeah, we have to... to bring it down. Really, we have to bring some down. Hopefully we will see some with a low amount of ammunition. The ships, and we can sink some. Or at least damage them so hard that as they have, some of them need an extended amount of time in port. So who is bombarding and attacking later on? Okay, so the cavalry division is bombarding, so we still see bombarding phase. Ooh. Harsh. The Philippine division really took a hit. Oof. Bad. That's really bad. He's still lacking heavy artillery. That's good for us. Okay, so the bottom phase should be pretty over soon. We go into the attack phase, right? Sugar tech will not do him a favor, to be honest. Yeah, heavy casualties. All over the board for him. Mortar bomber, mortar regiment is bombarding. No tanks charging these days. Interesting sound. Very interesting. Do we lose a lot after every charge? Nah, not yet. Maybe with the later divisions, with the newer ones arriving, that could be problematic. Hmm. but we still hold firm. It seems that's good. But with the first independent coast artillery battalion is pretty bogged. Yeah. The cavalry should take high casualties. Cavalry charge these days is a little bit problematic, to be honest. Yeah, 718 base, US Navy base force paid a high toll here. Yeah. Higher toll. Yeah. The question is how many supplies we have left after such an attack. Phew, such a high amount of bombardment and such an attack. Maybe 5,000. Not sure about it. Okay, 65th Infantry attacking, then we have 100th Imperial Guards Division as effective fighting force left. Yes, 118th Base Force and 101st Base Force loses some points in the Philippine Division here. But that's okay, no heavy casualties on our side for this attack. So he was us 0 to 1. Odds only 380 to 1800. Not bad. Not bad. That's really devastating for him. Wow. 3600 casualties and 46 guns lost. 600 men lost on our side and 6 guns. That's quite good for us. Yeah, definitely very, very good. Okay, he bombards at Tsingtao. That's the question why he's not deliberately taking it to Tsingtao. He should have more than sufficient force. Maybe not. We bombarded Tsingtao. He loses 90 men and 5 guns, and that was it for the turn, so. And thank you for watching. Servus. And with many stukas.